Dear students, today we will be discussing about the physiology of respiration, part 2. The part 1 involves the introduction and the transport of oxygen. In the second part, we will be discussing about the transport of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is a byproduct of cellular respiration, which is transported from the tissues through the blood and expelled out through the lungs. Transportation of carbon dioxide occurs in three ways in human. Firstly, in physical solution, that is dissolved in the plasma, which is around 7%, as carboxyhemoglobin or carbaminohemoglobin, which is around 23%. And thirdly, as bicarbonates in the plasma, which occurs around 70%. In physical solution, that is, the first one is the dissolved in plasma. About 7% of the total carbon dioxide produced as a product of cellular respiration from tissue is transported up to the lungs through blood in physical solution, that is, plasma. Carbon dioxide diffuses from the blood and combines with water in plasma and gets converted to carbonic acid through a catalytic activity of an enzyme called carbonic anhydrase. You can see in the reaction, carbon dioxide combines with water to form carbonic acid in the presence of enzyme carbonic anhydrase. In the form of carbonic acid, carbon dioxide is transported up to the lungs. And the carbon dioxide which reaches the lungs, you know how it goes out of the body through the respiratory system. Carbon dioxide that's released diffuses into the air sacs, which are also called as alveoli, and is eliminated or expelled through lungs by a process called as exhalation. So that is one process. The second type is as carbamino compounds. About 23% of the total carbon dioxide produced as a byproduct of cellular respiration is transported within the RBCs to the lungs in the form of carboxyhemoglobin or carbaminohemoglobin. So this reaction is rapid and does not require a catalyst, since carbon dioxide readily binds directly to the amino group of globin and not heme. Carbon dioxide is loaded in the tissues where the carbon dioxide is higher than that of the blood. That is, the pressure of carbon dioxide is higher than that of the blood. As a result, it diffuses out of the tissue into the blood and readily binds with reduced form of hemoglobin. When the blood is rich in carboxyhemoglobin, reaches the lungs, carbon dioxide readily disassociates to form carbon dioxide, which is exhaled out. So the next type, we see that as bicarbonates in the plasma. The largest fraction of carbon dioxide, that is about 60 to 70%, formed as byproduct of cellular respiration is converted to bicarbonate ions and is transported via or through plasma of the blood. At tissue levels, in the diagram you see that what happens in the tissue level, and on the other side what is the reaction which occurs in the lungs. So here in the first part, at tissue levels, you see that the carbon dioxide diffuses from the tissue into the RBC, where it combines with water to form carbonic acid mediated by the enzyme carbonic anhydrase. So in the diagram you see here, the carbon dioxide diffuses into the RBC, where it combines. Here it combines with water to form carbonic acid mediated by the carbonic anhydrase. This process is called as chloride shift or Hamburger's phenomenon. The bicarbonate ions which have diffused out of RBC into the plasma combine with various ions such as sodium or magnesium to respectively form bicarbonates and are transported back to the lungs. So these are the two parts what you see in the this picture. One which happens at the tissue level and the other reaction which occurs in the lungs. What happens at the level of lungs? At the level of lungs, where the partial pressure of oxygen is high, bicarbonates disassociate from anions and enter into the RBC to form carbonic acid mediated at the enzyme carbonic anhydrase. As a result, chloride ions shift back into the plasma. The carbonic acid disassociates to form carbon dioxide and water. Carbon dioxide thus released diffuses into the alveoli, which is expelled out. Thus, hemoglobin plays very important role in transporting atmospheric oxygen, forming oxyhemoglobin, and supplies oxygen to all the tissues of the body, essential for oxidation and metabolic activities. And then it also helps in transporting back the byproducts of metabolism, that is carbon dioxide, out of the body. Thank you, students.